And we're back. This is Local Biz Now, and this is a section of our program we call Coach's Corner. And there is no better person to lead that discussion than my buddy and co-host, Wayne Bidelman, business and marketing strategist and coach to many business owners in the area. Take it away, my friend.
Well, thank you, Joe. Love that music. Feel like I should do the bossa nova or something like that. The question today is, as a business owner, I know I should be thinking and planning about my future and the future of my business. How would you recommend I go about that? You know, that's a great question. And the first thing I would say is figure it out. You've got to take the time to think about what could happen down the road with your business. Just make the time to do it. Now, it just so happens that I've done organized a seminar around this very topic. And what I ended up with is that there are three things to think about when you're thinking about the future of your business. One is, I'll say all three of them first, maximize the value, protect the value, and then plan on how you're going to use the value. Maximize the value, protect the value, and then plan on how you're going to use it. Now, by maximize the value, I mean, hey, you know, get out of the day-to-day from time to time. You do have to serve the customers, but be doing all the things that maximizes the value, which by definition means if you had to sell your business, could you sell it at top dollar? I'm not saying whether you plan to sell it, intend to sell it or not, position it as if you were and maximize the value. The second thing is protect the value. Now, I'm not an attorney or an insurance provider, but there are all sorts of contingencies that you should address. Probably the biggest horror story I heard one time, Joe, was that a guy had owned his business for decades and had built a very nice business. He thought, in fact, he had even discussed it with his number one employee, that he figured when it was time for him to move on and retire, he'd just sell his business to this number one employee, and they'd even talked about it a little bit. Well, so happened, something came up, the guy died, the owner died. And so what happened? His employee went, set up his own business, took all the customers with him, set up his own business, and immediately had this whole cadre of customers. And so the original business lost all its value. The guy's heirs, his wife, got no value out of that business because he hadn't stopped to think about what would happen should something happen to him. And so it's not only maximizing the value, but protecting yourself against all contingencies, which is why you should always try to maximize the value, because you just never know what's coming down the road. Then the last one is planning. If you intend to leave your business, either pass it on, have somebody else run it, or sell it, do some planning. Figure out, hey, what do you want to do in retirement? When do you intend to do it? And how much do you need to get out of your business? We've even talked about this, Joe. You've helped me sometimes with clients. Okay, this is this kind of business. You know, how do you think somebody's going to value it, you know, if they had to sell it tomorrow? And then we back into it. We come up with a plan that gets them to the point that they need to be when they're ready to retire. Another way to plan is set up the right corporate structure, invest any free excess cash and assets in something that's going to minimize your tax load and take maximum use. It's one thing to build maximum value. It's another thing to get maximum value out of what you put away, what the value of the business is. So make sure that you plan around and protect yourself so that it isn't all eaten up in taxes. So those are the three pieces: maximize the value, protect the value, and plan how you're going to use the value. Because hey, this is your business. You know, you've done blood, sweat, and tears. You spent time, money, and a lot of effort. You might as well get the maximum return from it. Anything you got to add, Joe?
Yeah, just a few things, Wayne. From where I stand and my vantage point on this, it's really important. And again, I'm a guy that tries to be specific and add real detail. It's very hard to do that with these Coach's Corner questions for me, because I don't know who the person is that's asking. I don't know the industry. But in general, what I would say is you have to know the value of your business and how we came to that value. You've got to know what multiple we're using to give value to the business. You have to know whether it's a multiple of sales, multiple of cash flow, what does the inventory contribute to the sale price. And so knowing the value of your business and how we come to that value is really important in this process. So that's the first thing I would tell you, is make sure you know how a potential buyer or partner would value your business. The second thing I'd like to say is the way you do most of the valuing of a business is through these benchmarks. You can decide and discern through industry averages whether or not your company is being run efficiently, and that process, I think, is going to help you discern where you need to change some things or protect certain things. For example, the example you just gave, I can't believe he didn't have a non-compete or some type of employment agreement that would prevent that guy from doing that. But again, if he doesn't, and the point that I'm making here is, if you'd have come to somebody like me, that's probably the first thing I would have talked about. Hey, we need to secure the clients, and the way to do that is to make sure that your partner slash key employee has some type of non-compete or employment agreement that gives them value. Gives him first right of refusal, but also he can't just take what it is that you guys have built together and move on. And it's through valuing the business that you ask these questions, and then you'll come up with those answers. So that's where I would be on this.
Exactly, Joe.
Exactly.
And I was going to add, and don't go out and spend thousands of dollars to have somebody value your business come and talk to you. And I'm not saying you're not worth thousands of dollars. All I'm saying is, you know, it's going to be what someone's going to pay for it ultimately. And you've got the best feel for that. And so they can come up with that. So anyway, that's been today's Coach's Corner question. They're worried about that they're not thinking enough about what they are going to do and what the business is going to do in the future. Hopefully we've given you some good advice. So if you've got any questions you'd like us to discuss on Coach's Corner, let us know here at the station and we'd be happy to talk about it.